Who is the king of football for you? If we talk about each of us separately, then this is a simple question. But if the things get down about collective consciousness and recognition, then this is an endless discussion. In our favorite game, it is customary to call one person the king of football. Well, you know, let's say it all together. The king of football is Pele. However, time passes, records are updating, new generations make wonders, and a logical thought arises. Why do we still call that exact footballer the king? Seems it's time to break these stereotypes, because recently Pele has significantly lost some of the greatness he once had. Today, the Inside Football channel will try to convince you that Pele is not a king anymore. Let's get going! What should we start with? Of course, with the latest events. Cristiano Ronaldo breaks Pele's record for the number of goals in official matches and was voted the most productive player in history. The Portuguese has delivered 770 goals, three more than the now ex-king of football. Due to this occasion, Cristiano even received a gold jersey from Juventus president Andrea Agnelli. The greatest of all time. Today, as I reach the point of 770 official goals in my professional career, my first words go straight to Pele. There is no player in the world who hasn't been raised listening to stories about his game, his goals, and his achievements, and I am no exception. And for that reason, I'm filled with joy and pride as I acknowledge the goal that puts me on the top of the world's goal scoring list, overcoming Pele's record, something that I could never have dreamed of while growing up as a child from Madeira, wrote Ronaldo on Instagram after reaching a record mark. Pele responded to Cristiano's words with dignity. He didn't argue and recognized Ronaldo's record. Cristiano, life is a solo flight. Each makes his own journey. And what a beautiful journey you are having. I admire you a lot. I love watching you play, and this is no secret to anyone. Congratulations on breaking my record of goals in official matches. My only regret is not being able to give you a hug today, wrote Pele on his Instagram account. Yep, you heard it right. Pele really recognized Ronaldo's record. Remember the recent story spread by the world media, in which Pele appeared as such a child who drew statistics on his Instagram page. The best scorer in the history of football. 1,283 goals. Proudly flaunts the inscription in the bio of the legend's profile. At the beginning of the year, January 4th, reports began to appear in the media that Pele changed the number of goals in his Instagram page in order to prevent the current and future football stars from eclipsing his record for the number of goals. These stories have gained many clicks and views. But Pele himself denied this information, tweeting the following. I was accused by the press of having changed my Instagram bio to overshadow these big stars that are breaking my records. The bio text has always been the same since I joined the platform. None of this should distract us from your incredible achievements, wrote the Brazilian. In fact, we have great respect for responding to the press attacks. And we also have a portion of respect for Pele publicly recognizing the records of Ronaldo and Messi. By the way, about Messi. As you all know perfectly well, Lionel broke Pele's seemingly eternal record for the most goals per club. Pele scored 643 goals for Santos, Leo conquered this record in December, and now the Argentine is only increasing the gap. When the heart is overflowing with love, it is difficult to change our path. Like you, I know what it means to wear the same shirt every day. Like you, I know that there is nothing better than the place where you feel at home. Congratulations on your historic record, Lionel. I admire you very much, Leo Messi. The Brazilian wrote on his Instagram. I'm grateful for such a heartwarming message, Pele. It was very nice of you. These words mean a lot to me, considering that they were said by a great football player. Many hugs to you. Messi replied. Once again, Pele is worthy of our admiration. Most recently, Messi broke another Brazilian's record. Lionel became the most effective goal scorer in the history of one league. The Argentinian has 467 goals in La Liga. Barcelona has immediately announced a new record on its website in a pompous way. Leo Messi breaks records almost weekly. After the match against Real Sociedad, he now has 700 goals for Barcelona, 663 in official matches and 37 in friendly ones. There has never been a player like Messi, and probably never will be. This makes him the top scorer of all time in one league. In major European leagues, the all-time strikers are Jimmy Greaves, England, 357 goals, Gerd Müller, Germany, 365 goals, Silvio Piola, Italy, 274 goals, and Delio Onis, France, 299 goals. "There is no one even close to Leo Messi," says the message. Interestingly, the voiced version of the message has been edited. Pele was also mentioned here. The Barcelona media team removed the mention of the Brazilian, which sounded like this. Besides that, Pele was leading the world till the last moment with his incredible number of goals scored in Brazil. There has been some controversy over whether his goals were scored in the São Paulo State Championship, but none of that matters anymore. Messi, in any case, caught up with these stats. One more goal and he will set a new all-time record. Sounded in the first version. Well, one thing is definitely clear here. Surely Messi will score at least one goal, and therefore he will definitely outstrip Pele in the statistics. World media reported that the great Brazilian scored the same number of goals while playing for Santos between 1956 and 1974. It is noted that Pele is the leader in the number of goals scored in one league, despite the dispute that he counts goals in the São Paulo State Championship, since the Brazilian Serie A was created only in 1971. Well, in general, you got the point. As usual in the case of Pele, there was some confusion in the calculations, but this is not the main thing in this news. The fact remains the same. This record of Pele had also fallen. In terms of the greatness of Pele, many different myths has already been put up on the discussion table for many times. Our team, not being lazy in a thorough study of the facts, will give you a few more pessimistic ones for assuring you that Pele is undoubtedly a great player, but not a king of football anymore. Let's go! It's believed that Pele netted 1,283 goals, but only 767 of them were scored in official matches. Cristiano Ronaldo noted that in his Instagram post. Perhaps Cristiano Ronaldo has been a little hasty to declare himself the most effective footballer in history, since there is still Josef Bitzen, who is credited with 821 goals. The Czech Football Federation recently wrote about the matter. Respect for the performance of Bitzen, and we are to move on. Who has scored the most goals in the World Cup history? Not Pele, but Miroslav Klose, with an amount of 16 goals. Who scored the most goals in the World Cup final? Not Pele, but Englishman Geoff Hurst with his hat-trick against the German in the 1966 World Cup final. Who has scored the most goals in a single World Cup tournament? Not Pele, but Just Fontaine, 13 goals at the 1958 World Cup. Who scored the most goals in a single World Cup game? Not Pele, but Oleg Salenko, 5 goals against Cameroon national team at the 1994 World Cup. Pele participated at 4 World Cups, but he never became the top scorer in any of them. Pele claims that he won 3 World Cups for Brazil. But in 1962, Pele made only 2 appearances back then due to injury, scored 1 goal, and the main player of that squad was Garrincha. Pele was a groundbreaking player, one of the best in history, but football is a sport of a team, and if Brazil won the 1962 World Cup without Pele in the lead role, then it's worth giving credit to his teammates who provided the very 3 World Cup that Pele loves to brag about. The Brazilian national team made Pele the image of the king of football, but we know that every year he has less and less reasons to be accepted as the greatest. It seems that nowadays the whole king of football concept is no longer relevant. A lot of great players appear throughout football history, and you don't have to win 3 World Cups for that credential. Do you agree? Pele, Diego Maradona, Lionel Messi, Cristiano Ronaldo, Michel Platini, Ronaldo, Johan Cruyff, Ronaldinho, Gerd Müller, Gianluigi Buffon, Lev Yashin, Paolo Maldini. Okay, that's time to stop, I guess. We have so many remarkable and terrific players out there, and among them there can be one king. And we suppose this is the most correct thought of all possible. New matches, new records, and new heroes are soon to come. Someday the time will come for Messi and Ronaldo to leave the stage, because players such as Haaland and Mbappe are already asking for places under the sun. Friends, we hope you liked our new video and you will give it a like. And of course, give us a subscribe. Well, it was Inside Football. We watch football from a different angle. Have a nice one and see you in a bit.